Hello, this is Palico Paja, and welcome back to more of the Curious Expedition Arctic Expansion. No, that's wrong, isn't it? It's Arctic Expanse DLC expansion. Yeah, so it's something like that. It's got snow in. It's got lots of snow in. We are on Expedition 6 of 6 with the new explorer, Roald Amundsen, and we are cracking on with the opulent. We're going to stick with opulent. Yeah. No, opulent. Yeah, opulent. Prehistoric lands. Well, I was thinking about this. I've had a little bit of a break of a day since the last expedition, and I can't make my mind up whether this game is harder or not. And I'm just picking well, and the luck's been on my side. It definitely seems that if you are playing the Arctic land and you get the cursed thing fall down where all the map starts to turn red, that is definitely harder. Hands down, that's definitely harder. But I'm not sure if the game is harder in itself, and I've just been well planned out. I am a veteran, you know. I have been playing this game quite a lot. I don't know if you've seen it. 100 episodes, you know. And I've done a song. Check it out. Anyway, Expedition 6 of 6. These guys seem to be in the water. I'm not going to judge. That would probably help us overall because, well, they're in the water. Let's just crack on. Enough jibber jabber. After a good night's rest, I boarded the ship. There were still some arrangements to be made, so I had one last pot of tea. The collector was eager to set eyes on which instruments we had brought back with us. Well, Mr. Collector, we have some flutes for you. Some horny old flutes. I sold him a horn flute. The collector was eager to look upon us which instruments we had brought back with us. It would appear he doesn't say anything different, so we'll just sell him all those. There we go. You happy now? You want more? More? No more. I'm all done. That's all I could carry. There's only so much horn I can take. The collector seemed delighted with what we had sold him. That's all I meant to say. Together with his newly purchased goods, he departed the harbour in high spirits. I had a fleeting conversation with a scout. He had acquired a treasure map that he was willing to part with for an appropriate price. Well, let's have a look. How much would you like, sir? Just 20? And it's weightless? I dig it. I'm fine with that. Deal. As I was one of the most famous explorers, my fame had spread amongst adventurous spirits. Many new recruits showed up to learn the truth of the stories surrounding my endeavours. Who did I want to recruit? So we have Nassim Baba. We have Gerard Malachkowi. And we have Captain Nathaniel Barlow. No, we're good. There is free food, right? Of course, Edmund. You, sir, have earned free food and drink. But no. No one else here can help us. I'm very happy with our setup. My heart jumped with joy as I heard that our vessel was prepared to leave the harbour. Well, we better purchase some equipment then. Right, so what are we likely going to need? I'm not really enjoying that. We're doing okay for food. But I think taking as many of the canned goods as we can would be good. There's no reason for us to keep any money back. We're going into a jungle area, so I suppose all the machete would help. We've bought the treasure map, so we're going to need at least one shovel. Medikits could possibly be needed. I don't know if it's worth taking some rope in case we find any shrines which need to be climbed. We've got loads of rope. Torches, could be lots of caves. Wouldn't be any harm taking all those, I suppose. They're getting the stack as well. We got the shovel, custom flares, medical balloons, weather balloons even. I don't know if to take the bullets. As it stands, there are going to be a few things I will be dropping anyway. Can we afford the bullets? We can afford the bullets. We might as well just stack up on whatever else we've got. So, because we can always trade them. So with that in mind, we will take as many medikits as we can. All of them, as it turns out. And then the rest in rope, because that will stack. Well, at least six will stack. And a shovel. There we go. Boom. Worked out completely. Just in time, our vessel was prepared to set sail. Well, let's skedaddle. Expedition 6. What are you giving me? Come on. Secrets. We like secrets. Secrets is good. So we're on the 9 region map. I'm not going to press the button to have a look around because it'll speed this up. And we're sailing gallantly in. Top right hand corner. That makes it good. The open sea were glorious to sail upon. Well, the open seas were glorious to sail upon. And I was somewhat sad when one of the crew called land ahoy. We'd arrived and it was time to sally forth. Well, I need to put some stuff into storage. I'm not going to sell it. Although I probably could. So what are we not going to need? We're not going to need the snowshoes, that's for sure. We took... Does it stack? Does Eagle Vision and Binoculars stack? That is a question. The pelts, they don't stack. I honestly don't know. I honestly don't know. Let's close that. How many are we overburden now? Is it just the one? Okay, so we need to drop one more thing. What are we going to drop? What are we going to drop? Take into consideration we might not be coming back. Well, we can always sell these, can't we? So let's put... Because we've got the teeth to sell. They are worth 20. They are worth 15. So we've got... that equals out completely. We've got 60 value there and 60 value there. Yeah. Okay. What's worth more if we take it back with us? That would be the polar bear belts. So they can go back. The rest I'm going to keep. We're good. We're good. Enough dilly-dally. Let's just get out of this wooden boat and go down. Right, let's have a look. So, yeah, 9 regions. Not too shabby. We'll see how much we can cover. It's fairly open so far, which is good. I suppose our viewing does help. As it stands, I'm not too fussed about going there because we're pretty full on stuff. Oh, and here's a village. So good thing we didn't annoy them. We can get rid of some of this stuff. Today we reached a village. Today we reached the camp of a peculiar race of large lizard people. The villagers observed us with curiosity as our trek arrived at their settlement. We were able to walk amidst their number freely, as though there was nothing unusual about our arrival. All the time humans come here, and we eat them. We eat them. The villagers observed us with caution. They were polite and offered us what they could. Well, what do you have? Ooh... Well, I like ivory and I like jewels. What do you like? Do you like pelts? You like pelts? I knew you like pelts. Right, let's... Oh, we haven't looked at our map yet. Let's offset the pelts with the berries. Berries? Or should we get torches because they stack? I'm not thinking this through because these are all going to take up space. And we're going to have to get back to the ship. So we're going to have to give them something else. Teeth don't weigh anything. Oh, I don't know. I don't know. I've just brought too much stuff along. That's the problem. I suppose it's a good problem to have. Unless we put our standing up. What at the moment? One. I suppose we are going to be looting and, you know, generally pillaging quite a lot. So increasing the standing probably isn't a bad thing overall. So with that in mind, you can also have... Do you like this stuff? Freestanding? And it frees up another space? I'm happy with that, I think. And we'll leave. It's been great. Thank you. Thank you. Right, so, map. Let's do the map before we do anything else. Right, so that would appear... That would appear to be there. So let's go there next. And then we'll go back to the ship with whatever we've got, dump the stuff, and then loop around properly. Oh. Volcano's going off, you know. So we'll use one of those. After many exhaustive hours and a broken shovel, we indeed found something valuable hidden beneath the surface. Ah, so we've got a dinosaur skull. We have a tome page of world creation. Okay. And we have a tome page of fertile lands. That will all come in useful, no doubt. And we are one slot over birdie owned. Is there anything we can eat to take up that space? Or anything we can drop? It pains me, but let's drop the shovel. I don't like wasting stuff if I can help it. Let's go back. We've got plenty of stuff here. Let's drop it all off. That seems very inefficient. Oh! Yeah, okay. That's on fire. Right, so we need to access our storage, and we want to drop off the jewels and the dinosaur skull and the... What else did we get? Is that it? Oh, the ivory. Elephant tusk. These don't weigh anything. We can trade in the treasure map along with the teeth. That's good. Yeah, that's good. And let's go back. So we are now going to drink some whiskey to get our loyalty up with the very fickle Edmund. And what's our standing for? We'll see what's here. And if there's any jewels or anything, then we'll look at taking it on. If there isn't, if it's just food and stuff like that, I'm quite happy to leave it. I inspected the mysterious man-made stone sculpture. The uncannily crafted eye seemed to focus on us. Its presence made me uncomfortable, and I decided to move on. I noticed some items by the statue, which must have been put there by the natives of this region. They were surely sacrificial offerings. Ah, jewels. Excellent. Well, if you're going to loot, we might as well loot, I suppose. We took what was useful to us from the offerings. And we're now on two. That's fine. We'll eat the evidence. They'll never know. 120. I'm going to go back. It doesn't cost a lot to go back. I'm going to go back. We're going to drop them off. Gives us time for this fire to get put out as well. So we shall now drop off the jewels, which will stack. Lovely, lovely. And get the bloody hell out of here. Right, let's go down to this one. What's this one now? 15, 16, 16. 16's good. Oh, slaver camp. Our trek stopped at a slave camp. An acrid stench of human excrement brought tears to my eyes, and several large cages were filled with all kinds of different people. A well-fed slaver welcomed me with an aloof manner. If we trade, do we automatically get our standing knocked down? We don't. As it stands... Oh, he's got a pistol. A signature pistol. Why not? Ooh, that's why. Okay, well, for the sake of trading one slot for another, I counter offer you with that. And we shall take more machetes, I guess. And no. Yes. No. Yeah, no, bullets. How many bullets can we have? 5 bullets. Good. So we'll deal with that. Minus 3 standing. That's fine. I dig that. And now we attack you. We use your own bullets against you. Wow. Okay. So what do we have? We've got the slaver who has 12. Slaver minion on 8. That's us. Hyena on 6. Minion on 8. Minion on 8. So we can take the majority of these down pretty much straight away. So if we shoot you for 2. Shoot you for 2. You're dead anyway. Are these all big claws? That's bloody good. What about if we do that? Right, 2 on you. And then he's got 12, so we can bring you down by 6. I'm relying on these two throwing up a head for me. So let's throw these up to get our defense up, just in case, because you know how it goes sometimes. Boom. Boom, I tell you. Boom! That's how you deal with slavers. After we defeated the slaver and his pawns, we stripped what was useful from their remains. Oh, gold. And, oh, well, we got one tooth back, I suppose. More bullets, excellent. More whiskey, sod it, we'll take it all. The slaves had noticed our fight with their former owner. The cages were broken quickly and people started running free. Confusion ensued. Newly freed people shouted and a fire started to spread. We had to evacuate before it was too late. That's alright, we've done our bit for the region. They love us, you know, they love us around here. Well, I'm not going to head back. We'll carry on going down. So we have raptors. What be you? Oh, a shrine. Well, let's just move down a little more. We stood before a temple comprised of huge stones. Its stone walls were covered with ornate engravings. The portal that led inside emitted an eerie chill. We found some sticks planted firm in the ground. Someone put ghastly human heads on their sharp end. Their mouths had been sewn shut as if to silence them. This is new. Human heads. We arrived at what seemed to be the treasure chamber. It was a truly awe-inspiring sight. We found a stone altar that was covered in ancient writings. God! And what's that? World creation. New stack. Awesome. What a glorious day. The artifact would sit atop the altar no longer. The world felt different all of a sudden. Whatever took the people, I hoped it would not take me. At least I got some peace and quiet. What? What? What took the people? What's that mean then? I was expecting zombies. What's going on? What? Okay, I'm guessing we'll see. Right, we are one slot over birdie owned. That's fine. We shall get rid of... Well, we're down to half health. Can we get rid of any food or anything? If we have... Because we've always got the camp site to fall back on. So let's just eat the chocolate. And we're good to go. And just crack on, I guess. Well, I guess we'll attack the raptor. Because why not? There, well, we've got 12 and 12. So good rolls, please. Yeah. Okay, well, let's take him down. We might be able to take a few out. We've got big claws on you. And then you can have some little claws. You can... Are they... They're just little claws. That's not good. Do you stack of anything? Oh, you do. Stable shots or stopping shots. Oh, we'll go with stable shot. Down to three. So we'll use claws on you. Throw in some bullets because we've got lots of bullets. And then we shall use... Oh, point blank on you. Boom! And we'll throw in another bullet because why the bloody hell not? Let's overkill it. And we shall take all the teeth. And we'll take the skin and drop the meat. We'll have a look in the stone circle. I don't think we're going to be needing to... I suppose... Runes would be good, just so we know where we're looting. Yeah, why not? Just the one? Just the one more? Okay. Well... Beggars and choosers and stuff like that, I suppose. Let's crack on. Oh, lots more raptors. Hang on, you weren't anywhere near me. Oh. That's it. Keep hitting everyone else. Oh, you're going to pay for that. Right, so. Roll for initiative. We can throw the dynamite down straight away. And then we're just going to try and take off as much as we can, really. So, stable shot on you. Down to three. So let's use a stopping... Well, sorry, point blank on you. Take you out straight away. Come back down to you. We'll use one set of claws and another bullet. And then claw it. I'm going to hold on to that. Roll again. You bastard. Okay, so. One more of those. Do you not stack? No, you don't. That's alright. I've wasted a bullet, but that's fine. I can live with that. Look at this. OT it. Okay it. Overkill. Is that right? TK it. Whatever. It's dead. Right, so we can take those, which will stack, and seven more. That's a full stack. Boom. And we'll have a look in the nest, because they had the audacity to kill us, or try and kill us. We approached what seemed to be the breeding ground of a raptor pack. I knew we had to leave as quickly as possible, as the raptors that lived here could return any moment. My instinct said we would find something of value here. We spread out and searched the area. We were lucky to find some old equipment on one of the humanoid bone piles that was serving as a grotesque decoration of this place. Ooh, more dynamite. You've got one. Machetes we've run out of. Would I drop anything? I'm very happy the way everything's going right now. No, we'll leave it. Right, so let's get some healings going. We set up camp to tend to the injured. Healings. And that's a dead region, which is good. So let's just move one more. Oh, you cheeky beggar. Right, let's get him on the go. Right, so another set of raptors. Same rules apply. On for you. Oh, bullet wall. Why not? Then we've got three, so we can do that. Point blank, we're not going to waste that on you. You can take that. And we'll throw one bullet in. Finish you off. Throw one claw in. And one bullet. That'd be you dead. And then claws. Claws. Two. We'll taunt it. We can always just throw some bullets in anyway. Roll it. Is that it? Fine. We deprived the dead of anything useful. We're out of space here. Let's take those. I'm good. Right, so let's travel down to here, because that'll open up that region. There we go. So just basically, so we can see what's going on in this side now. So that's that dealt with. What are you? Scorpion, that's fine. Well. I suppose we're going to come around here and down here and up and across. That would seem to be the most efficient way. So we can't cross this. So I guess we'll travel to there and then make our minds up. I'd like to start getting through some of these canned goods. So I might start moving this down. Well, we can walk around, you know. It's no biggie, I suppose. Why not? That'll do. More raptors. Do you think they get bored of dying all the time? Let us now eat some food cans. And do I want to go all the way down? This is going to end terribly. Oh, there we go. Great. Right, so more stuff to kill. We just need to bring them down to six. So with that in mind, headshot. Ooh, nice. Cool. And you, what would you like? Don't want to evade. I want to hit him in the face. Let's roll. So we use a quick shot on you. Come down to you. You can have strong claws. That's to eight. And then it's only one. I didn't want to use it, actually. Let's get this out of the way so I don't lose it. Well, again. Oh, we got it. We got it. Right. Oh, first world problems. Right, let's take all those. They definitely don't stack, do they? No, they don't. And we're not going to use anything else up right now, are we? No, we're not. We are getting through an awful lot of dynamite, though. That does worry me a little. I don't like this. Are you going to sell a light by any chance? I've got a funny feeling you are. I'm going to head in that direction and get ready to stop. No, we're good. We're good. So, explore the cave. Is there anything down there? No, I'd say that's pretty dead. We located a cave. The entrance led into darkness of unknown depths. We required a torch to explore its secrets. Ooh, show me! We lit a torch and descended into the darkness. We arrived at a small cavern jumbled with the debris of what seemed to be a failed expedition. The skeleton of what must have been a British explorer stared at us through cracked eye sockets. All the bones were found had been cracked open, and it seemed sucked empty of marrow. We were delighted to see that one of the corpses was still clinging to useful equipment. I would argue against that as far as usefulness is concerned. We could throw some weather balloons up just for the lols. Everything else is useless. Oh well, there's a pyramid. And again, I've got a cave. Okay. So, let's head to the pyramid. Let's see exactly where the shrines are. Because we've come across none. We've pretty much covered half the map here. And oh, that was lucky. Oh, what are you? Sabertoothed tiger. Oh, we're going to take you on. Right, so let's attack these raptors again. Yep. So, there goes the dynamite. And then we've got some big claws we'll use first. And you can have the... Ooh. Headshot. Yeah, you can just have normal claws. And then we've got you and you. Oh, shotgun blast. Oh, should have used that earlier. Even so. Roll it. Tart. Well, we're getting the skins, that's for sure. And I think I'm done. So let's see where the rest of everything is and go from there. We encroached upon an enigmatic structure. Huh. It seemed to be the pinnacle of a golden pyramid, but for some reason its structure was underground. Its golden surface was etched with all manner of otherworldly symbols, most of which formed a manner of map. Well, let's analyze that map. After a period of analysis, we could successfully comprehend the map. It was obvious that it showed some locations in this region. Maybe visiting them was necessary to unearth the Golden Pyramid. Well, of course. Of course. It's going to be the furthest point away because... Yeah, my life. Well, let's see what's in here in this cave. Yeah, we've got another question mark down here as well. Ooh, that looks like another written off region though, which is good. So let's explore. We approached a cave. The rocky moor led into the darkness of unknown depths. We required a torch to move inside. We lit a torch and descended into the darkness. We discovered a remarkable underground lake. The water seemed rich with algae, sustaining the growth of mushrooms with a vibrant hue. If we were to invest a little time, we would surely be able to collect a few samples. Well, let's do that. What is there? Nothing exciting. I was hoping for some of those greeny, bluey mushrooms to get rid of this guy's alcohol addiction. I'm happy to leave the mushrooms. And we'll go down to here. I understand we're running away from the saber tiger, but he will be coming back, so that's fine. Again, we're doing A-OK. I don't think there's much need to stop. No, we're not going to stop. We're going to crack on. First things first, we're going to go over here, which will enter us into this region and open it all up. Kind of. Even so, that's okay. And if we go to there, are we going to be close to this saber wolf? Bastard. Okay. Oh, get some more food cans, I guess. We'll go up to. Our reputation precedes us, obviously. You're taking the piss now. Cancel, 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 cancel. Right, so Raptor, let's take you down. Okay, that's fine. So, full fierce claws. Awesome. And then you, and you, and then. Ooh, you. And you. And roll. And roll. You can always rely on the head. And more skins, and thank you very much. It's been a pleasure. Right, there's another saber wolf tiger. So I keep saying saber wolf, don't I? Saber tooth tiger up here. So I'm not going to worry too much about this one. I fear we may cross paths again when we come back down to the pyramid anyway. So I'm not too fussed by that. Oh, you're not happy. We need to drink some alcohol. And fill up a little bit more. Can we make it over there? We can. Cool. We've actually missed quite a lot. That begrudges me. Even so, we approached a grand structure that seemed to be partially made out of pure gold. We discovered a mechanism of sorts on one of the sides. With a little time, we would surely be able to activate it. However, what would happen upon activation remained a mystery. Well, let's do it. After many hours of research, we were able to activate the mysterious mechanism. Is this good or bad? All of a sudden, an enormous column of light emerged from the seal. Cool, Daddy-o. We are quite far back. Right. Trying to strategize here. I have an idea. I have an idea. We are going to hit this question mark, and this question mark. We are then going to use, where is it? I know I've been holding on to you. Tome page of Homebound, which will take us back to the ship. We're going to offload all our goods, and then we're going to crack on this way to hit this one up here, and then loop downwards. That is the plan. So, with that in mind, let's check out this cave. I trust it's a cave. Yes, I knew it. We approached a cave. Its opening seemed to lead deep into the mountain. We needed a torch to uncover its mysteries. We have those. We lit a torch and descended into the darkness. We stumbled into a dead end. It obviously served as some kind of ceremonial tomb. Within were large wrapped bundles that seemed to hold the prodigious remains of dead bodies. Many of the mummies would surely turn to dust if they were touched, and not be of any intrinsic value. However, after a thorough investigation, we managed to find one that remained intact. Nice. Are we overburdened now? I think we are. Yes, we are. That's two up. I'm going to drop the cans. And we shall go down to here. That might burn out. Yeah, there we go. That's one less thing to go to, I suppose. That was probably a village or something. All right, so do we rest? Let's rest. Let's rest. This waterfall was quite enormous. It was an awe-inspiring sight. The water cooled the air, creating a fresh breeze. So let's rest. We settled down and I told the people to rest. One could cut the tension with a butter knife as we rested by the fireplace. Our people were becoming overwrought, and a discussion between Hubbus and Private Edmund Marks escalated into a raucous argument. A moment later, the pair were throwing fisticuffs and trying to strangle each other with grave intentions. Right. There's a strategy behind this as well. We're going to arrest Private Edmund. No, we're not. Oh. Our attempt to overpower Private Edmund Marks was ill-fated. He slipped away, yelled all manner of obscenities, and fled into the darkness. That was bad. That was very bad. After days of rest, we still enjoyed the rumbling of the falling water. The falls were glorious. Well, we better rest again. This was a good place, and I was sure we would get some well-deserved rest here. While sitting around the campfire, we heard what sounded like a fight coming from nearby. A young native was striving to fend off a wild creature. Well, as it stands, we are a place open in the troop, the trek. And I'm willing to throw it open to you if you survive this fight, strange native. Who are you? Toju Zokuyoki. And you've got dice, which is good, which is good. And we've just got three hyenas, which isn't too much to be worried about. So with that in mind, that's one down. That's you guys halved. That's you down. And have a nice day. We deprive the remains of anything useful, which is actually it could be something. Let's take these. Yes. Oh, are you stopping? I like to think you're stopping. Hey, he stopped. So, as you can see, we've got lots of points. So you're going to be taken straight up to top dollar. As we prepared for departure, I knew we would miss the peaceful hum of the falling water. This place buoyed my soul. We'll rest again. We decided it would be a good idea to stay here to recuperate. The air was fresh and cool, and as we prepared the campfire. Oh, that's the full sentence. I took great pleasure sitting by the crackling fire and took a moment to record my experiences, my personal journey. I noticed Hubbus observing me closely. So that should be us up to tip-top shape. Awesome. After days of rest, we still enjoyed the peaceful hum of the falling water. The place buoyed my soul. So, we got a fire. That's fine. We're not too fussed by the fire. We are firstly going to upgrade you all the way. That's how we roll. And then we're going to use the tome page of Homebound. Cool. Return to the ship. We're going to access the ship's storage and get rid of the mummy. All the gold. What else can we get rid of? I don't think you can sell these. No. Those sell. That is a tidy profit right there. So let's get rid of those. I don't think there's anything else we can get rid of. In all fairness, we have opened up quite a bit of space there, so I'm not too fussed about anything else. Yeah, that'll do. That'll do. Yeah, plenty of space. So let's get back to the expedition. So we're sort of starting afresh now. That is all clear. So we might as well just sort of head for this question mark here and see what it is. 42. Sounds good. With our eagle vision, we should be able to open this bit up as we pass it, unless there's any sort of jungle in the way. Well, whatever's there is going to be burnt up, that's for sure. Yeah, it's definitely nothing there. We would have brought that up quite easily. And we have a cave. We located a cave. The rocky moor led into a darkness of unknown depths. We needed a torch in order to venture forth safely. We lit a torch and descended into the darkness. We were surprised to see this was just the beginning of a subterranean route. We've got the torch. We'll use it. We explored vast caverns and twisted corridors. When I finally saw light ahead, we moved towards it in earnest. Was it like a big loop? Oh no. Oh, okay. It's alright, it looked like that one. Okay. Well, as it stands, this is nearer the pyramid. So let's go back. Da-di-da-di-da, explore the tunnel. Yes, we're all good. We're all good. So that's going to flood. So we'll come down to this one, by which point this should be open. Up to there, open that up, up to the top question mark, back to here, through the cave. boom, boom, bada boom, on the way home to certain riches and glory. So this question mark first. We did have the sanity for that, right? Oh, look at you, Mr. Bird. Thought you'd been clever, stalking up on us, and you get burnt to a crisp. Later, loser. The village was empty. Oh, okay. There were signs of a fight, but the attack was nowhere nearby. I searched but didn't find anything of use. Right, so that's what that does. Wow, is that a bad thing, really? It means if. Yeah, because let's face it, minus six, they're going to be sending people after me by now, and it's only going to get worse. So that's probably a blessing in disguise. With that in mind, let us drink some alcohol. And did we eat all the chocolate? Yeah, we finished the chocolate off. Oh, okay. So 44. What about for a more direct route? 47. I dig it. So we'll open you up. We approached a mysterious structure that seemed to be partially made out of pure gold. We discovered a mechanism of sorts on one of the sides. With some effort, we would hopefully be able to trigger it. However, we would happen upon activation remained a mystery. Yeah, we know what's going on here. Yeah, that's all good. Right, so let's drink more alcohol. Is that going to get us there? Just about. A mighty banquet. Oh, another village, which is going to be empty, no doubt. Oh, it's an elephant graveyard, even better. This bleak and ancient place was situated in the midst of a swamp, scattered with the remains of long dead elephants. For some unfathomable reason, hundreds of the impressive animals had come here to die. Okay. I was certain there were riches to be found here. I instructed the people to form small teams and investigate the surroundings. Just the one. That's fine. That's fine. And, well, onwards, I guess. Or should we rest up here? We are relatively safe up in this corner. This isn't going to flood any further. We're definitely not going to come first. So, yeah. Why not? We assembled our camp. It only increased my yearning to sleep on a feather mattress again. God, he's such a spoiled brat. Feather mattress. Just get some long grass, shove it underneath. It'll be fine. Let's rest. We settled down and I told the people to rest. It was a pitch black night as we sat and stared into the fire. It took but a second to discover the reason why Toju Zoyuki woke me up in the middle of the night, panic in her face. Oh, she's a chick? Fair enough. A thing had burrowed itself deep into her ear. She screamed as I removed the creature with a pair of tweezers. The bleeding was easily taken care of, but the ear was a complex apparatus, and so it did not surprise me that she sustained some hearing loss from this episode. She was not amused at all, but I hoped her hearing would eventually recover. That's fine. We're fine. Sleeping with a roof over one's head was a luxury we were seldom afforded. Well, let's do it again then, if you liked it so much. We settled down to recuperate. It was a warm and starry night. Hope beside me through the cold eyes of a card sharp. Whatever that is. I soon found myself challenged to a game of cards. Oh, okay. Well, why not? So we deal it. Twice over, friend. Imagine his surprise when I calmly nodded while he explained the rules. They revealed that I had won multiple tournaments already. Needless to say, I won. I think that's supposed to be needless to say. Well, Sanchez back up. That's good. I think that's enough to be getting on with. 108. Only a bit short. So let's pack up the camp. It was time to break down the camp and make headway. I told everyone to put the equipment back into the crate so we could depart. And on to the cave. And we should use another torch. Back through. We've done all this bit. Let's do it again. Boom, he says. And, well, yeah, let's do the whole loop. So, up here first. Cave. We approached a cave. The entrance seemed to lead deep into the mountain. We required a torch to move inside. Oh, abandoned. Who by? Doesn't say this time. We arrived at a small cavern jumbled with the remains of what seemed to be a failed expedition. No nationality. We were delighted to see that one of the corpses was still clinging to useful equipment. So we have a page of Eagle Scout, a page of Hill Creation, some canvas and some torches. Why not? Take it all. We can afford to. And let's, yeah, loop on round. 100. Or shall I rest? How close can we get? Not too close. We'll put ourselves out here. We'll stop on the desert. If anyone gets close, we'll kick their ass. I think that's how we'll do this. So, rest overnight. Hubbard's found an alluring mushroom. We were investigating it and wondered if it was edible, when it suddenly squirted a foul-smelling fluid at us. Hubbard was unwary enough for it to completely cover his face. He remained somewhat unmoved, probably shocked. Soon his eyes turned greyish and he had trouble recognising how many fingers I was showing him. I could only hope that this was not the final end of his sight, otherwise he would be of little use on this expedition. Well, I'm sure it's not the first time he's had strange stuff squirting in his face and forgot to close his eyes. He looks like the type. Sleeping with a roof over one's head was a luxury we were seldom afforded. Let's do it again. I instructed the trek to halt and told the people to rest. It was a beautiful night and everyone seemed to enjoy themselves. This night we could hear the sound of drums from somewhere in the jungle. Can't happen. There's no villagers. We passed the night around the fire trying to decipher the underlying message of the drums. They're trying to tell you that they drink mbongo. Because they drink it in the Congo. Do I want to rest up again? No. Let's go for the seal. We're probably going to have to fight the raptor, which is fine. Or raptors, should I say. We've got two lots of dynamite left, which means we're going to be having at least one fight without dynamite if the animals stay where they are right now. But for the sake of not taking any damage up to that point, then we'll just do the usual. Multi-attack? Boo, wait till it happens. Come on. Claws, that's what you needed. Right, so we'll take everything. And click on. So this is the final seal, right? And then we've just got to hit the shrine and get the bloody hell out of here. Oh, I've done it again. Oh, every time I do that, I forget to pack up my camp. That's not good. That's not good. We'll have to go back and get it. So that is the seal. That is the pyramid. Yeah, because we've only got two. Yeah, I've got to go back for it. Rubbish. What a noob. We're taking on a scorpion. No, he's staying away. Although we can see us from above the hill, he decides not to attack. The night was bleak and everyone seemingly worn out as we sat and stared into the fire. Sometimes camp proves to be the most dangerous parts of an expedition. Hobus wanted to demonstrate his supposedly powerful kick on a discarded bottle. He missed his target by far and instead kicked a solid rock. The next hours, he spent uselessly hopping on one leg. I scolded him. We were an expedition, not a field hospital. Although we do have the medikits to look after you, sir. My life, what's wrong with you now? Capacity minus one. Okay, well, can we get away with that? No, probably not. It was a beautiful night and everyone seemed to enjoy themselves. As we watched the campfire's mesmeric embers, Hubbard expressed his curiosity of how his life would unfold post-expedition. This would probably be our final adventure together. Oh, they're getting all whimsical on me. Well, I suppose I have been through quite a lot. He has been here from the start. He's seen it all, as Hubbard. Sleeping with a roof over one's head was a luxury we were seldom afforded. Let's back it up and get out of here. Boom. Oh, yes. Yeah, that's good. So let's go. If he gets close, we attack him. That's close enough. Attack saber-toothed tiger! ! Oh, it's two of them. 20 health? Oh, I'm glad I kept a dynamite back. All right. Oh, we've got all the bullets as well. I'm sure we'll be fine. So, first things first. Let's you down to a little bit. Then if we throw you out and you out, that's another multi-attack down. Bloody big claws on you. You and you, stable shots, or bullet wall. But we are using up two dice instead of one. I think we're going to be okay here, he says. Damage of three, or a damage of four. We'll take it. Awesome. Didn't expect that to pan out like it did. We deprived the remains of anything useful. Well, we're definitely going to have that. We're definitely going to have that. I'm not fussed by those. We're almost there. We've killed everything. The meat's useless. We'll get rid of that. Cool. Onto the shrine. We arrived at a long-forgotten shrine. All manner of plant life grew towards the sun. A circle of dried-up blood that had been drawn around the whole structure as a warning for anybody that dared to enter. The building was cold to the touch. There must be some scientific explanation for this phenomenon. Interesting. Before us lay some kind of ceremonial room. It was a truly awe-inspiring sight. I held my breath as we discovered an ancient altar in its centre. Ah! Right. So, rope can go for the jewels, and torches can go for the golden Henry VIII. I would not leave empty-handed. The treasure was to be mine. I stepped into a cold pocket of sorts. I could see my own breath crystallise in the air, and every breath was like tiny needles were being jammed into my nose and throat. That's not very good. Even so, on our way back now, 100%. Really? Looping up. Where the hell were you taking us then? Well, let's drink the last whiskey. How far can you get us before we need to set up camp? Oh, actually, you can get us all the way there, the long way around as well. As long as we don't run into the scorpion. So how much more is it to come this way? No guts, no glory. Let's do it. Oh. Well, that's okay. We made it still. Oh, where the hell have you come from? Angry lizard people. You abandoned your village and you were nowhere to be found when I needed you most. And now suddenly you're miraculously back and pissed off at me. Well, I'm gone. I'm done. I've pillaged. We've got everything. Boom. The exotic landscape complemented the extraordinary golden pyramid. We'd overcome all events to achieve success. Yes. We have one sanity to go. After weeks of travelling, tremendous relief overcame me. I knew that this name, Roald Amundsen, would be respected within the community of intrepid adventurers. If only you knew. If only you knew. We have kicked ass. So we've got the golden pyramid. We've got a new world bonus because it's the last one and it's a fancy prehistoric place. We're last. Doesn't matter about that. So brave. So brave. We've triumphed. That's it. Look at that. God save the Queen! And, well, I'll be interested to see if anyone gets close. We don't even need to do anything. And we're still there. I could put all my riches down now. But for the sake of a couple of old subscribers of mine who do get quite annoyed when I don't put all my money into the fame to get the highest possible score, that is what we're going to do. So let's gift the gold, gift the jewels, gift the ivory, gift all the teeth, the lots and lots of teeth. Look at them all go there. We're going to gift the pelts. We're going to gift even more teeth. We're going to gift the raptor stuff, because why not? Let's do this. Saber roof, gift it. Fangs, gone. What were you? I've completely forgotten. Polar bear pelts. Into the museum. The head of the Triceratops. Boom. Mummies. Gold raptor. It's all done. It's all for you. British Museum. It's all for you. I will die penniless, but knowing that I am the man. That's good enough for me. Well, it's good enough for anyone, really, isn't it? But it's more so good enough for me. Who needs money when you have a statue and a golden portrait? You know, we don't need material stuff like cash. Where's that going to get you? I'll tell you what it's going to get you. Well, it's probably going to get you a lot of happiness, but it's material happiness. It doesn't need anything. I mean, I could have had both, but chivalry is not dead. This is the 19th century, damn it. Chivalry's not dead. Not yet, anyway. Congratulations. Rank first. Look at him with his little purple chin. We have a final score of 3,858, which is not too shabby at all. Roald Amundsen returned to the peaceful valleys of Wales in triumph. After he secured his legacy with a splendid statue, he enjoyed a happy life in the knowledge that history would regard him as a prime example of a hero. Wales! He's from Norway. Why would he go to Wales? Why would anyone go to Wales? I've been on holiday there. I would not go back. I'm going to tell you a little story. We went on holiday to Wales a couple of years ago, and it hadn't changed from when me and the girlfriend went when we were kids. That's not a good thing. You expect things to adapt, to evolve, but no, everything was exactly the same, which is okay for like the little fishing villages and whatnot. We loved walking around those, but there's a theme park called Oakwood that hadn't changed at all, which is a bad thing in 20 years. And it was this place called the Crystal Maze, which was based on the TV program, but instead of it being sort of actual doing stuff like it is in the London one, you had like screens where you had to complete challenges, and then you went to a big crystal dome where you had to push buttons. That shut down. That was depressing. Anyway, I digress. Toju Zoyuki returned to her home and lived a secluded life. After some years, she released her memoirs, which became an overnight success and made her the talk of society. She stayed in contact with most of the other survivors and corresponded monthly until her death years later. During her late life, she became obsessed with recurring nightmares about a remaining mysterious pyramid. She disappeared without any trace. You just told me she died. So how can she disappear? Or did she disappear and they presume she died? Hubbus remained in the Western world and never again returned to his old home. He did not cease wearing his traditional clothes and even inspired a fashion boom during one particular summer. He lived a long, quiet life and died in the presence of his faithful spouse. And boom, there we go. That is the full playthrough with the new explorer, Roald Amundsen. And we have got him a statue and a golden portrait, which I think concludes our playthrough with him properly. I won't be returning to him, but I am sure we haven't done everything in his new expansion. So the next time around, we are going to be looping it all the way back to episode 1 and replaying the game with Charles Darwin, simply because I never did an introducing. We don't know who the guy is. We know about the Darwin Awards and the Origin of the Species, but who is Charles Darwin? Who is old Charlie? What did he do other than those two things? So that's what we're going to be doing next time. We'll be having a playthrough on good old Charlie. I'm not sure if we're going to do it as a certain death. Again, I'd like to play it through on normal at least once more, just so we can try and experience everything we can. And I really want to bring up the cursed worlds again, so I could do a nice rounded person to do that on, and also have it on a relatively easy difficulty so we can actually explore it properly and not just get killed straight away. And then after that, maybe I'll do a few more exhibitions. What I might do, I'm going to throw this out there now, so see what you guys think, if you've made it this far into this video. It's a pretty long video. I'm willing to play with some bonus characters. Now, again, I know it's just remixing what powers that other explorers have, but even so, if there is a certain character or famous person or YouTuber who you'd like me to play through this game with, write down in the comments below, give me their pin code, and if it's someone interesting enough, I will do it. And we'll do an introducing episode on them and break it down like that. I think that'll be good, and it's a good way to extend this and not get bored with who we're playing with, because as I said, we have played through with everyone now. So I'll leave it at that. Write down the pin code down below of who you'd like me to play through. Give me a reason on why. Why not? And I'll make an educated decision on that. But for now, Thank you for watching. As always, a like is appreciated, and I'll catch you on the next one. Take it easy.